we wanted just to make a house that was all about the view. In a snowstorm, it's like being caught inside a snow globe. Most ski chalets are characterized by a certain chunkiness. They're not necessarily oriented around views or exteriors, but about creating an interior sense of maybe coziness or enclosure. And that was very much the opposite of what Jeff had asked me to do.
This is my 50th year skiing because apparently I was skiing before I was walking. It's always been a big part of me growing up in New England. So the idea of having a ski home has always been a dream of mine.
Jeff had been looking in the Stowe area to buy a lot or a property for at least 10 years, I think. Once he found this property, I immediately told him that he had to buy this one. Mostly because of this beautiful blue stone, three-sided hearth that we rebuilt the house around. The house extends in these three square wings from each of the sides of this triangular hearth, and each of the wings extends into a different landscape.
I really wanted the house to feel like a ski house. So in several of the bedrooms, I have, you know, vintage ski posters from Stowe. The andirons in the fireplace behind me were done by a local blacksmith. I wanted people to walk into the space and say, wow, this is a ski house.
We designed parts of the house for very specific sort of use narratives. And the idea was that after you come back from a day of skiing, you want to warm up in the sauna, look at the trails that you've just skied, and pick out a bottle of wine for dinner.
I wanted a house that was modern, something that wasn't fussy, that was really low maintenance, that would handle skiers and dogs and muddy hiking boots.
And so we wanted to select materials that were indestructible. A black polished concrete floor, granite, solid walnut and sapele. The entire material palette should feel, I think, warm and inviting, but durable.
I met Jeremy shortly before purchasing the house. You know, it was very early on in our relationship, so there was a little bit of hesitancy in mixing our personal life with his professional career. But, you know, very early on, it was apparent that we were going to treat me as a client.
It's a pleasure to spend time in a space where the mode of inhabitation has been so intimately designed for someone I love and for us to live in it together.